Good morning, students. How are you all? I hope you all are fine and doing good. Now, as you know, we have completed the sixth chapter and the grammar topics also. Fine. Now, today we are going to start a new chapter, and it is a poem. Poem 7. Okay, it is number 7 chapter, and it is a poem. It's a beautiful poem, and it is about water. I just want to say you that the poem is about water. It is very easy to understand, and it is a very, very short poem. Okay, so today I will be just reading out the poem, explaining you, and then I will also show you the animation of the poem. Okay, students, so are you ready to learn the poem? Come on, let's learn the poem. Okay, students, so this is the 7th poem, What's Water For? And we are going to do the first part today. That means this is the first video. Now let's see what is there in this particular poem, okay? Okay, students, so this is the 7th poem. The name of the poem is What's Water For? Okay, now we will see what is, it is on page number 41. Now we will see what is given in the iConnect part. What's water for? Is it only for drinking? Make a list of all the possible answers to the above question. So now this is your activity of the iConnect part. You know that in every iConnect part there is an activity given to you. Now what you have to write here is, now you use water for many things. Yes or no? It is not only used for drinking. So you use water for many activities throughout the day. So you have to write over here for all the possible things you use water for. Whatever you use water, you can write anything you want. All the activities, the names of the activities you have to write here. Suppose, for example, drinking, you can write drinking, cooking, whatever you want to write. So you have to write it over here in the space provided. You all must be knowing very well about this, right? You must have done it in your science also. So very easy activity for you. Okay, fine. Now we are going to go to the next section, that is I read. What is given? First, a description is given before the poem or the lesson. There is a description given. We will see what is given here. Water is one of the most important resources that nature provides us and is essential for the survival of all plants and animals. Read and enjoy this poem, which describes the various uses of water. So now this poem is about the uses of water. Okay, it is given on the next page. So we will see what is given about water in the poem. This poem is about water. This poem is written on water. Okay, fine. We will read the poem. Water is for drinking and making tea, for helping plants grow and for washing me. Okay, so here it's given that water is for drinking. You use water for drinking, you use water for making tea. Then the water helps for the plants to grow and for washing me. Whenever you want to wash yourself, that means you want to wash or have a bath, then also you need water. Without water, it is not possible, right? So you use water even for having bath. Then, water is for swimming and having fun, for wetting my brother and making him run. So here it is, some funny lines are given, that water, you use water for swimming. When you want to go swimming, of course you need water. So that is for swimming. Water is for swimming and having fun. And when you want to wet your brother, that means when you want to put water on your brother, when you want to wet your brother, make your brother wet and make him run. So you, when you put water on your brother, of course he is going to run. So when you want to make your brother run, you will put water on him and then he will start running here and there. Yes or no? So it is for wetting my brother and making him run. Water is for fish that swim about fast, for boats that move with a sail and a tall mast. So water is also useful, very important for fish, for the fish that swim very fast. Yes or no? So water is needed for the fish also, so that they can swim in the water, so they can live in the water. Then, for boats that move far, that move with a sail and a tall mast. And it is very necessary for boats also. You know, this is called a sail. Can you see this boy? He is in a boat. This is called a sail. Yes or no? So, water is important for the boats also. Water is important for the boats also. If there is no water, the boats will not be able to move. So, the boats with a sail also, they need water and a tall mast. Now, what is the meaning of mast? A long pole in a boat to hold the sail. Can you see this long pole? Over here, there's a long pole, like a wooden. It is made out of wood, a long stick. A long wooden stick. So, this is called a mast. This is called a mast. So, water is necessary for the boats that move with a sail and a tall mast. So, whichever boats are moving with a sail and a tall mast, water is very necessary. Okay, without water, they will not be able to move. Waters for kingfishers. What is kingfisher? Brightly colored fish-eating birds with long sharp beaks. So, kingfishers, you know, they are very bright colored birds. They have red color in their, they have red, yellow, all the bright colors. They are made up of all the bright colors. And they have very long and sharp beaks. If you want to see the picture of a kingfisher, you can just see it on net. You can find it out on Google and you will get beautiful pictures of kingfishers. It looks very nice. It looks beautiful. So, they are fish-eating birds. So, even water is necessary for kingfishers. Waters for kingfishers, red, white and blue. What is this gray? Do you like it too? So, even for the kingfisher, it is necessary because they catch the fish in the water. They eat the fish from the water. So, it is even necessary for the kingfishers. Okay, it is the name of bird. And water is just great. It is showing, the poet is telling that water is very great. Do you like it too? And then he's asking us a question at last. That do you like it too? And of course, your answer will be yes. Everybody likes water. There is no person in the world that don't like water. Because water is so important. You cannot live without water, right? So, this is a beautiful poem, right? Very simple, easy. I will just read it once more, okay? What is for drinking and making tea, for helping plants grow and for washing me. What is for swimming and having fun, for wetting my brother and making him run. What is for fish that swim about fast, for boats that move with a sail and a tall mast. What is for kingfishers, red, white and blue. What is this great? Do you like it too? So, this was our poem. Okay. Now, I will show you an animation of the poem so that you will enjoy understanding and learning the poem. Okay. So, let's see the animation also.
What's water for? Water's for drinking and making tea, for helping plants grow and for washing me. Water's for swimming and having fun, for wetting my brother and making him run. Water's for fish that swim about fast, for boats that move with a sail and a tall mast. Water's for kingfishers, red, white and blue. Water's just great. Do you like it too?
Okay, students, so I hope you have understood the poem. It was really interesting, right? You learnt about different uses of water through a poem also. Yes or no? So now today we have learnt the poem, seen the animation also. So in the next video, I will be discussing the exercises of the textbook, that is the checkpoint section and the I understand section. Okay? So this was a video for today. Thank you for watching it and have a nice day.